The Bacolod Public Plaza remains as a constant reminder of the city's rich history and at the same time narrates to its residents and visitors the significance of being a community that was brought to sophistication and saw and survived the test of times. Situated at the center of the busy Rizal Street and adjacent to the iconic San Sebastian Cathedral, the Bacolod City Public Plaza is a 2-hectare land that was set aside by Spanish authorities in the early 1800s. When Bacolod was declared as the capital of Negros Occidental in the 1850s, the development of the plaza was initiated.
Because of colonization, our society began to be sophisticated, no, and complex. So hindi na linear, but we began to be a little bit circular. So that is why may concept of the plaza. And well, quote-unquote, thanks to the colonizers, we were introduced to their concepts of the parks or the plaza in Spanish. No? From the transfer of the capital of Negros Island from Himamaylan to Bacolod, to the Bacolod municipality of Bacolod, that was in 1847, this plaza was allocated a space pa malang to anay with some few flowers, etc. No? Now, in 1927, that was already the American colonization period. This was the plaza, which was built by the Spaniards, was reconstructed as it is now in 1927 by a certain American pensionado, engineer Monico Puentevella Jr.
The plaza saw its facade touched by two settlers, the Spaniards, who donated the land, and the Americans, whose reign also prompted its reconstruction by allocating enough funds for the area to be made of concrete, as well as the construction of benches and fountains. Its current design is clearly American, from the famed bandstand to its classical plan.
Very apparent, very evident that the design of the Bacolod City Public Plaza now is what they used to call moda americana. This is really very American. All over the United States, you would see vacant lots with a bandstand, like what the bandstand we are standing on right now. No, this is what we call the American bandstand. It's a gazebo, no? It's a gazebo. So, sa America, madamo umumuamos ini. Basically, because a plaza or a park or a square is where people gather together for leisure, relaxation. No? Other countries in Europe, in US, Australia, Canada, no, invest heavily in a plaza. No? Green, serene, simple. Just like our public plaza, no?
The iconic checkered flooring of the plaza was once considered to be the epitome of Bacolod. Whenever one speaks of the city, the plaza and the black and white tiles would always stand out. And it did so before our famous festival was created by the local artists.
This American Bacolod Public Plaza bandstand with checkered flooring was the signature. You may not be born yet, no, sa itong mga panahon, pero amo ni anay ang signature. Whenever you talk about Bacolod City, amo ni gagawa sa mga photos, inang checkered flooring niya, kag ining American bandstand with the classical musical composers sa babaw sini.
Also present in the bandstand are the names of the world's foremost composers: Ludwig Beethoven, Joseph Haydn, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, and Richard Wagner. This also represents our past and the way our forefathers embraced the American culture. This, however, overstepped two silent icons that stood witness as Bacolod saw its name evolve from a municipality to a chartered city in 1938.
I love most is the Tindalo Tree, which the late President Manuel Quezon planted when he visited Bacolod City during the proclamation of the Charter Day of Bacolod City, which is October 19. And it is somewhere here in the north of the plaza. I think makita sa camera ta. It's towards my right, no? Northern part of the plaza. I've written about this before. There is a lonely tindalo tree there, no? As if waiting for people to gather around its stems. And it tells a lot of stories. It can tell a lot of stories because that was planted in 1938. Ginapabalo sa tanan ang the tomb of the unknown soldier, arada, tomb quote-unquote. Ginapabalo sa tanan nga kunili tungod sa ila, hindi kita hilway. Hindi kita hilway magpangabuhi sa siyudad sa ngatong Bacolod.
Aside from the inauguration by then President Manuel Quezon, the plaza also became the centerpiece of the city's prominent names and leaders, as well as another historic event in our history.